Welcome everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk and today is a basics video just showing you how to update to Android 10. So for me, very luckily, I've got a Pixel 3a and a Pixel 3a XL. The Android 10 is now available to download. It's also available to download on all current Pixel devices, and then obviously when the Pixel 4 launches, it will come with pre-installed software. So Android 10 finally drops the names of the desserts. They couldn't think of one for Android Q and we've just gone to the numbers now. Android 10. Simple. Easy, and let's see how easy it is to install the software. Step one of this process is to make sure that you have backed up your device, backed up your photos, backed up your documents, or backed up your whole device itself. You can of course use the Google services to do this. You can use the Google Photos, and also you can use the Google Drive as well. I've made sure that everything is all backed up on my devices and they are ready to go. Also, you'll need to know that you have done all the latest software updates, which include a security patch. So you'll do that first, and then it will show you the actual Google Android 10 installation option. So to find this, what you need to do is swipe up. We're then going into settings. In settings, go to system. In system, go to advanced. And finally at the bottom here, we've got software update. So tap on software update and it says system update available. Introducing Android 10. And there we go. You can see on both devices, my Pixel 3a XL on the left here, Pixel 3a on the right, it's got introducing Android 10. So coming down, you have more information here, which we're going to go through, but also Android 10 is available to download on these current phones. The Sony Xperia XZ3, the Huawei Mate 20 Pro, the LG G8, the Nokia 8.1, Vivo Nex S, OnePlus 6T, Vivo Nex A, Oppo Reno, Xiaomi Mi 9, the Asus Zenfone 5Z, the Realme 3 Pro, and the Xiaomi Mi Mix 3. 5G plus others as well, and I'll put a link in the description so you can see which devices are available, plus all current Google Pixel devices all the way from the first Pixel device. So on our display here, let's have a look to see what it actually says. It says introducing Android 10, new ways to customize your phone, control your privacy and get things done. Also, it gives you a website here so you can go and learn further information if you so wish to. And then coming down, it's saying about new features. So new features include dark theme, navigate your phone with gestures, additional controls for privacy and location, quick actions and replies in notifications. Then obviously you have your download size here, which is 1,188 megabytes. And then we can set that to download. So I'm just gonna click both here. Scroll back up to the top and it's going to start to process my download. Please make sure your device has significant battery. As I said there before we started, please make sure you have backed up your device before initializing the software update. So both of the phones have downloaded the software now and it says to tap to restart. So we're going to restart our devices. To be honest, it really didn't take that long to download, and then obviously the install process, very quick and very easy to do. But if you do have any questions or if you are stuck at any point, drop a comment down below. And you know, as always, I try and reply back to near enough every comment I receive on the channel. If you haven't yet already seen my unboxings and my setup and also the accessibility plus a review on both these devices, I'll leave links in the description. The 3A has completed first. It's going to ask for my code, and the 3A XL is not too far behind, and again it's going to ask for my code. Swiping down, it's just saying here it's finishing system update. It'll be the same on this device as well. No, this one's all completed. So now if we go into settings here, all the way to the bottom, go into system, we go into about phone, then Android version, Android 10. There we go, we've got Android 10. You can hear the haptic sort of vibrate in the background there. Android version 10, double tap this Android, there we go. I can move this around again, have a bit of fun with that. So now both of our devices are updated to Android 10. Let's go through the key features. And I've noticed with the key features, they've got a real good precedent of talking about accessibility and actually really updating some great options here for accessibility needs. So the first one is live caption. Automatically caption media playing on your phone. With a single tap, live caption automatically captions videos, podcasts, and audio messages, even stuff you record yourself, without ever needing Wi-Fi or mobile data. data. That's really impressive. The next option they want to talk about is Smart Reply. So take action right as you reply. In Android 10, you can get more than just a suggested response to your messages. You also get recommended actions. So if a friend asks you out to dinner, your phone will suggest you text like a thumbs up, and then it will also pull up directions right in Google Maps. This even works in other messaging apps. Again, this is another great accessibility option here, which is called Sound Amplifier. So hear what's around you more clearly. With Sound Amplifier, your phone can boost sound, filter background noise, and fine-tune to how you hear best. Whether talking to your best friend, watching TV, or listening to a lecture, just plug in your headphones and hear everything more clearly. Again, a really good feature here. Gesture navigation is another option you're going to see in Android 10. So with the Google Pixel devices, we're so used to sort of gesture controls anyway. So swipe up will bring like this little option here. You've got your applications. You can clear all, you can swipe all the way up here, all of your open applications. Obviously you can swipe to go left or right, or you can swipe to go backwards. Loads of different gesture control options. Obviously press and hold in will launch Google, but plus with these devices, you do have the squeeze effect. So what they're saying with other devices, you can get around with a swipe and a pull gesture, and now quicker and more intuitive than ever. Go backwards and forwards, pull up the home screen and swipe to see your open applications. All a lot smoother actions. So I'm looking forward to seeing that when I get an Android device that is going to be running Android 10 that previously didn't, where it might have had the three capacitive buttons, so the home, the back, and the menu. But now with gesture controls, it's just going to be so easy and simple to do. With the Pixel devices, it is already that easy to do. So again, another great option here that a lot of people have asked for on multiple different devices, and we finally saw it on iOS, and we've had it on Android for a while, and that's dark theme. So take it easy on your eyes and on your battery. Android's new dark theme uses true black to keep your battery alive longer. Plus, it also changes how your Google apps look, like calendar and photos. So we're gonna swipe up, go to settings here. So inside settings, you do have a search option. But if we go down to display, then go into advanced, already here, dark theme, got it. Just makes it so much easier to read for me personally. It's awesome. So coming home, as you see, our Google bar has changed here compared to here. So if I swipe up here, show you my application, swipe up. It just makes it so much different and so much more easier and clearer for me to read. So showing my notification bars here, you can see the two differences. And again, this will work in different applications. Swiping to the left here, you've got the two different options, but it just makes it so much more easier to read. Obviously, if you've got an AMOLED panel or an OLED panel, it's going to really save your battery as well. So the newest and game-changing devices, foldable and 5G devices, are only available on Android. So you can get to experience the latest and greatest features on devices that fold, flex, and move faster than ever. And this is so true. So currently, Apple just released their new phones. No 5G, no folding device, same iOS, same sort of looking devices. Android is flexible, that can work on any device that may fold, bend. Even Huawei Mate X, I see it running Android. Then obviously on 5G devices, such as my Samsung S10 5G that I've got currently, the Xiaomi Mi Mix 3 5G that I've looked at, plus also other future new 5G devices that we're potentially seeing from Google. So it is ready. The software is ready to just manipulate and work on whatever device that you have that is capable of running Android 10. Currently at the moment, we are very focused on our data and our privacy. Keep your data private with more control. With Android 10, you're in control of your privacy. That's because you get new, smarter controls, lets you decide how and when data on your device is shared. So you can rest easy, which is a really good thing. I recommend going through changing your data and privacy depending on what applications you use and obviously what websites you use. So they talk about getting security updates faster, which is really helpful. Android devices already get regular security updates, and in Android 10, you'll get them even faster and easier. With Google Pay system updates, important security and privacy fixes can now be sent directly to your phone from Google Pay, the same way all your other apps update. So you get these faster and as soon as they are available, which is really important because if you don't have these security updates, your banks may not allow you to use your cards in Google Pay, and you might have issues using Google Pay overall. Another thing Google touched on during their I/O event was digital well-being. Quality time is different for everyone. For some, it's unplugging on the weekends. For others, it's spending hours video chatting with your best friend. Android 10 gives you the tools to find that balance. The next option is called Focus Mode. We've also seen this before on other devices like Zen Mode from the OnePlus 7 and 7 Pro series of device. Focus on what's in front of you for getting in the zone and blocking out distractions. Focus Mode is now in beta and lets you select apps to pause temporarily. So if you want to turn off a distracting app to get something done, all you have to do is tap. So we'll look into that and see how well that works and make us more focused on our work that we need to do. The next option is talking about Family Link. Set digital ground rules and help make healthy habits. Help guide your children as they learn, play and explore online. You can set screen time limits, view app activities, manage apps and content restrictions, and see where they are. That's really helpful for parents that are a little bit worried when they're maybe getting their first smartphone. As you know, children these days, I've been on a bus, train, plane, traveling around the world, and I've seen people just bury their heads in phone, and that includes young children as well. We do need to be worried that we're not just giving them a device to make them quiet, not just giving them a device to keep them happy. We need to engage with children and then engage in our world that's around us. We live in a beautiful place and we need to make sure that we're not living our dreams on our phones, but we're actually living our dreams on the world that we're actually in. So please make sure that you look at Family Link and actually set ground rules and set sort of limits and set time for your side to be a family and set times to just enjoy being with each other. And that is the key highlighting features. Plus there are so many more. And what I'll do is I'm gonna go through the accessibility settings of Android 10 again in a separate video and looking to see what has actually changed from a previous model to this model. So I'm looking forward to seeing how well that works. If you have any questions about updating to Android 10, how it's worked, how well I'm doing with it on my Pixel 3a and 3a XL, please leave a comment down below and I'll be more than happy to help. Also, while you're leaving a comment down below, make sure to hit that like button and become a subscriber to Tech Talk UK1. From me, Ricky, thanks always for watching and I'll see you very soon. Bye for now.